My name is Dave Welsh. I own Pixie Video Productions. After three meetings with Pat Carroll, this interview ensued. Known for your comedic ability. In school, were you funny? Were you the class clown?
Well,
I guess you should ask
that question, because one of the nuns in high school, I was a very shy little girl, very, very shy.
I don't believe that.
It is true, David. I wouldn't fib to you. And one of the nuns at Immaculate Heart High School where I went to school, one day I was late for class, and I crawled in on my knees, and she caught me. And she said, "Patricia Carroll, you'd do anything to get attention." I thought, well, I guess I should be an actor then.
And here you are.
And here I is.
How did you get your start in show business? What was your first big break?
I don't know if I've ever had a big break, David. I'm still waiting patiently for that big break. I can't think of anything that was a big break. I've just been fortunate enough to keep working professionally since 1947. Isn't that wonderful?
That's fantastic.
Every day I say thank you, Lord, because this profession, bless it, is probably the most insecure business in the world. And anyone who enters it will quickly learn either to get out or to stay in it because they love it. And I have a younger daughter, Tara Carsian, who has been in the business now for 20 years. And she says, "Mother, if I could do anything else, I would, but this is the only thing I really love." I said, "Then don't leave it. You keep doing what you love, no matter what the insecurities are. That doesn't make any difference. Everything is insecure. So you might as well do what you love." Mm-hmm. Am I right?
You are right.
Good.
Did you find much resistance to the idea of females entering into the comedy field?
Oh, females have always been in the comedy field, David. It's just that a lot of people were prejudiced against them. I think it always went against the female image for a woman to be funny. But within families everywhere, they talk about Aunt Tilly, who is a hoot, and Grandma Marion, who will just keep you in stitches. Women have a sense of humor, always have had. In many cases, within families, they've been the only ones to keep the beacon of laughter alive. And I just think that the translation to the theatrical profession was not difficult for women, except for the prejudice of people who did not want to see them acting silly. They wanted them to maintain themselves as ladies. Well, please forgive me, but ladies have a sense of humor as well. I think it was mostly gentlemen who did not wish to see ladies out there making, as my grandmother said, making a fool of yourself. I always loved that. But I do think that we have come a long way, and I think Lucy Ball set the standard for ladies in comedy because she was quite lovely to look at. She could be a glamour puss one second and the next minute be trying to make those cookies go faster in the factory.
Now this is your last chance. If one piece of candy gets past you and into the packing room unwrapped, you're fired.
Yes, ma'am.
Let her roll!
Splendidly. Speed it up, oh!
Epitome of a woman who could do or be anything. She was also really, I think, a quite good serious actress, but she, after the success of Lucy, she did not want to disappoint her fans, so she continued doing her comedy. And, you know, she learned to do comedy at MGM under the aegis of Rags Ragland, an old burlesque comic. And that dear man, you know, who was as big and as good as Chaplin with the sad puss. What is his name? That escapes me. My years show up
Buster
right.
Buster Keaton?
Buster Keaton, yes. You win.
Okay.
You win the big prize this evening. Buster Keaton and dear Rags Ragland were under contract to MGM, but their job was not so much to act in front of the camera, so they did do that, but they started a comedy school at MGM to teach young, burgeoning actors and actresses for the films to do comedy. Lucy used to talk about how they would make them take home props and work with the physical prop until it was second nature. And if you think of Lucille Ball on her program dealing with stilts or dealing with anything that was physical, an object, you knew she was in charge of it. It wasn't in charge of her. She was, I think, brilliant at prop work and comedy. She was just wonderful. But I think Lucy really changed it for young women coming into the theatrical profession because she broke the mold. Mm. And I think she made everybody realize that women could do comedy without changing their feminine characteristics at all. Now, she could mug and act up a storm and black out her teeth and do anything she wanted, but you always knew it was pretty Lucy under there. And I think she really helped every young girl who wanted to do comedy more than play heavy, serious, dramatic roles. And I bless her.
Pat, your talent put you in great demand for early television. You did the Danny Thomas Show?
Yes.
You did the Dick Van Dyke Show?
No, I didn't.
I thought you, I saw
no.
you on one. Didn't I see
no,
you on
that was
episode?
On the Mary Tyler Moore
Mary Tyler,
show. Where,
I
do you know
pardon.
I got hate mail because of
Why?
That? Because I was so mean to Mary Tyler Moore? I tell you, I got hate mail. How dare
really?
You treat our
oh,
Mary that?
Goodness.
And I wanted to say, I get paid for that. I love Mary. She's fabulous.
Did you ever play a villain?
No, not to my knowledge.
Was
People
Ursula
may have thought
villain?
I was villainous, but no. And I had a ball
yeah.
because I conceived Ursula to be a used car salesperson who had formerly been a Shakespearean actress. That image so hit me when I got it. And, of course, the way the animators drew the figure, you got so much from the drawings of that character. But she was such fun to do. To be mean is fun.
Yeah.
It is just delicious to be villainous. I loved every second of filming that, and I've delighted in it ever since then.
Since you worked with many stars, who
wasn't
you...
I lucky?
You were. Who would you say was the most fun to do a scene with? Do you have any recollections of really just breaking down because it was so funny?
Yes, and there are many stars that I worked with that tickled and delighted me. Danny Thomas was a little minx, but my favorite was Jimmy Durante because I had
really?
Adored him since I was about knee-high to a grasshopper. And I got to work with him. I had done a special in New York with Max Liebman, and Jimmy was the guest star. I was so excited. My heart was palpitating. I get to meet Jimmy Durante. I get to work with Jimmy Durante. He was an angel. He was exactly what you see was what you got. The man was extraordinary as a human being. I would go to lunch with Jimmy, and people were walking off the street because they heard Jimmy Durante was in there. Presidents of corporations, senators, presidents of banks, a guy who was digging a ditch. He covered everybody because they knew this was a piece of honest goods. Jimmy Durante wouldn't lie to you. Jimmy Durante wouldn't be mean to you. He might pronounce some words incorrectly, but that yep. was the worst thing he would commit. The man was a gentle man, if there ever was
one. You're giving us a lot of insight. I hadn't realized.
And he made me laugh constantly because when he would mispronounce something, Jimmy really did not realize that he had done that. I mean, he wasn't doing it as part of an act. He was doing it because that's the way he was. And he wouldn't realize that he had said that. And he just, well, number one, I was so in love with that dear man and the way he worked that to work with him, which I only did once, that one time, was a treasure for me. I've never forgotten it. I came home with a big smile on my face every day. That man tickled and delighted.
Did you ever have the feeling that you wanted to go and still have the feeling that you wanted to stay? You knew it was right, wasn't wrong. Still, you knew you wouldn't be very long. It's tough to have the feeling that you wanted to go, still have the feeling that you wanted to stay. Start to go, change your mind. Start to go again, but change your mind again. It's tough to have the feeling that you wanted to go, still have the feeling that you wanted to stay. Don't bring me for so less.
Peter, ready? 1 minute. Here's the first word. Go, Peter.
Gold.
Silver.
Cookie.
Oh, and read it carefully.
I hate to be superior at this late date.
Cookie. Oh. Pasta.
Pasta.
Spaghetti.
Noodle.
What is that?
Cheese.
What?
Cheese.
The macaroni.
Vino.
Wine.
Soprano.
Alto.
Male.
Baritone. Tenor.
Tenor. Pants.
Or trousers.
This is the delightful stage and television comedian, Pat Carroll.
Thank you, and this is my partner, Fergus Curry, from New York City.
This is the comedy star and popular MC of Who Do You Trust, Johnny Carson.
Thank you, and this is my partner, Maureen O'Shea, from Detroit, Michigan, and we're all here to play Password.
And now here's your host on Password, Alan Ludden.
Good evening. Welcome to Password. We're very happy this evening to have as our guest Pat Carroll. Hello, Mother.
Hello, Father. How are you?
I'm fine. It's good to see you again.
Thank you. It's so good being back.
And Johnny Carson. Good to see you, Johnny.
Thank you.
Pat?
Sir.
I watch you on the Danny Thomas show, and it looks like you're going to have a baby.
We aren't sure which season, but that...
You're going to be on it next season, though.
Well, it looks like if the baby doesn't arrive this season, we'll have to wait until...
The following program is brought to you in living color on NBC.
A Great Dane makes a good family...
much poorer.
Pat Carroll.
In college, students live in a...
state of confusion.
No, in a dorm. Mel Dorme.
Oh. And I'm Tom Kennedy, name of our show, You Don't Say. I'll buy that. Thank you very much. You've helped us welcome our stars, Pat Carroll and Mel Torme. And, of course, we all welcome back our current champion, and contract administrator, Errol Stevenson, and our challenger...
Last question. Why did you pick Cape Cod to retire to?
Oh, for a very good reason. There was a huge earthquake in California.
It tossed you right out of the state?
Talk about being a wash ashore. That's a long wave that took me here.
It took a long wave to get you here.
But it was 1994, and the very horrendous Northridge earthquake occurred, and I was staying with my two daughters. It scared the living daylights out of me, Dave. It scared me to pieces. I woke up at 4:30 in the morning and found God again. I tell you, I was one frightened creature. And I don't know that I could live in Los Angeles again because my fear was so great, and I just knew I couldn't stay in
L.A. Cape Cod doesn't rumble too much.
Thank God.
Thank God.
It snows and there's some rain occasionally, but aren't we lucky on Cape Cod this year? I'm telling you that. But that's the reason I came to Cape Cod, and I couldn't be happier I made that decision.
Thank you, Pat Carroll. We've enjoyed spending some time with
Thank you. Thank you, David. I've enjoyed talking to you. Bye, Pixie.